They ignored my research that could have saved lives. Chinese virologist hiding in US blows laid on China. The coronavirus pandemic originated from the wet markets of Wuhan and it snowballed into a global pandemic when China colluded with the World Health Organization, WHO, and tried censoring information about the deadly respiratory virus. Several reports and exposes have stated that the Xi Jinping regime knew about the virus way back in November-December 2019. Now a Chinese virologist by the name Dr. Li Mengyan has come up with claims that stamp authority on the fact that the Chinese government indeed knew about the novel coronavirus well before it claimed it did. Speaking to Fox, Li Meng, a former University of Hong Kong researcher, mentioned that she fled Hong Kong leaving her friends, family, and her job as the Chinese authorities were hounding her for blowing laid over China's mishandling of the pandemic. The virologist, speaking to Fox from an undisclosed location, revealed that she first became aware of the human-to-human transmission capability of coronavirus in late December when a scientist at China's Center for Disease Control, CDC, shared data with her. However, when she presented her findings to her supervisors on January 16, she was warned not to touch the red line and to be careful about her comments. Yan, who previously worked at the university's World Health Organization, WHO reference lab, also iterated that her supervisors, renowned as some of the top experts in the field, also ignored the research she was doing at the onset of the pandemic, which she believes could have saved lives. Yan, now in hiding, escaped Hong Kong on April 28 in a Cathay Pacific flight and landed in Los Angeles, where she was questioned at a length by the FBI, Fox confirmed. The researcher has claimed that the red authoritarian government of China is trying to silence her by shredding her reputation and choreographing cyber attacks against her. Li also said that her family was being put under duress and that her apartment was tossed all around by the local authorities. Yan also claimed that WHO advisor Malik Peiris knew about the spread of the disease but chose not to take action. Peiris was until recently the co-director of a WHO-affiliated lab. He stepped down on July 3. While giving rationale to her idea of fleeing Hong Kong, Li made a rather distressing statement stating, "I know how they treat the likes of Dr. Ai Fen, Dr. Li Wenliang and probably hundreds of other doctors whose story couldn't even come out in the public light." Whistleblower Dr. Ai Fen, who was one of the first Chinese doctors to bring to light the danger of the virus, was quickly silenced by Beijing and has not been seen in public since March. Dr. Ai Fen had spoken about the coronavirus outbreak in an interview to the Chinese magazine Renwu or People in March, in which she had disclosed how she had found several patients with flu-like symptoms in the month of December last year who were not responding to the usual treatment methods. She later also received a lab report about one of the patients which contained the words SARS coronavirus. Dr. Li Wenliang, another Chinese whistleblower doctor who sought to alarm the world about the impending pandemic, was silenced by the Chinese Communist Party, CCP, and unfortunately, later succumbed to the virus in February. Yan's interview contradicts both Beijing's claim that it did not withhold information about the danger of the virus and the WHO's stated lack of awareness of the overall risk of the initial outbreak. On January 14, the WHO came up with the now infamous tweet where it stated that there was no clear evidence that the coronavirus could spread between people. Despite the mounting evidence from several Chinese doctors, Taiwan, and several other countries, who sided with China's lobby and kept the entire world in dark. The infamous tweet of WHO will be etched forever on the internet as a living example of one of the biggest blunders in humankind's history that led to the loss of thousands of innocent lives. WHO has to inadvertently bear the brunt of the loss of all these lives till the time it exists. The world has started standing up to China and it is the duty of a country like the USA to keep whistleblowers like Dr. Li Mengyan safe from the clutches of CCP.